Hello, check. All right, people, I believe we are live. Welcome to Catalysis by Vedantu. Let me check the camera setting once. And if I'm audible and visible, please write yo in the chat box. You know the drill. Just focus wagera set karna ho yaar ekdam. Haan, this looks fine. Yep. We are good to go, people. Aur toh sab badhiya. So, welcome to the second class of the chapter of solid state, yes. And in this class, we are going to learn more about what are Bravais lattices, what are these unit cells, how do we visualize these unit cells, yeah? And in these unit cells, if there are atoms present at different positions, then what is the contribution of their number inside the unit cell itself? Yeah, cool. So that is what we will discuss today. So this is a discussion that we had started in the previous class of solid state, which was the first class, just a normal information class. So 3D unit cells are various lattices, you know, can be formed by varying the unit cell parameters. So how do we figure out the unit cells? We take a 3D system like this. Okay, this 3D system has six variables essentially. What are the variables? Edge lengths A, B and C, interfacial angles alpha, beta and gamma, and then locations of atoms or ions with respect to each other. Do you understand what's going on? Do you understand to an extent what we are trying to do? See, imagine I tell you, okay, imagine I tell you, in two dimensions, try to figure out the different ways in which I can make a two-dimensional figure which has four sides. You understand my question? We have to make different two-dimensional structures which have four sides. So what are the kind of structures that I can make? I can make a simple square. Yeah, then I can make a rectangle. What did I vary? Over here, A and B both were same. Over here, A and B are different. A and B being the lengths of the cube. Yeah, so this is A, this is B. Yeah, so now A is the same, but B is different. Yeah, so A and B same gives you one type of a structure. A, B different gives you another type of structure. What we also can do is, you know, do something like this. Now the angle has also changed. Yeah, I change one of the angles, it changes, yeah? So this becomes a parallelogram. You know, I can make a rhombus as well, where A and B are the same, but the angle is a little different, yeah? Now these are very standard, simple structures. We could make something very weird as well, right? Kuch bhi bana do. Here A, B, C, D, everything is different and all the angles are also different, yeah? So depending on how you vary these, you can get different structures for these two-dimensional figures, yeah, which have four sides. Kuch bhi bana sakte, you can make something like this as well. Yeah, doesn't really, I mean, it's not very easily imaginable, but this is also a four-sided figure, yes. Ye must ek isme obtuse angle hai. So with such different combinations, instead of two dimensions, we have to think about these things in three dimensions now, yeah? So what do we have? We have a box. Alright? We have a box like this. What are the parameters that we can change? The parameters that we can change are A, B and C. A is this height, length. We can call this A, this B, this C. Just giving you an idea. We can change the height, we can change the length, we can change the breadth. Yeah. What we can also change are these angles. Theek hai? I'm just going to show you which angles we can change. We can change the angle between these two. We can change the angle between these two. We can change the angle between these two. So on and so forth. So three angles and three sides can be changed. Those are ABC, alpha, beta, gamma. Okay? So I'll show you again. Edge lengths A, B and C. Interfacial angles alpha, beta and gamma. Fine. In this figure, I'll mark things once again so that it's even more visible. This is your A. Okay? This is your B. And this is your C, right? And what are the alpha, beta, gamma? This is alpha, this is beta, and this is gamma. See, no need to remember which particular angle is alpha, no need to remember which particular angle is gamma, etc. These are just names. I hope you understand the significance of them. Exact figure, you don't need to remember it. So ye to idea lag gaya ki, achha, by varying these parameters, I can get different unit cells. What was the definition of the unit cell? Unit cell is the smallest unit which I can repeat again and again in three dimensions. to get my solid lattice once again. It's like the wavelength of the entire solid lattice, huh? ठीक है, wavelength होती है waves के लिए. Over here for solid lattices we have, you know what it is. Yeah, voice का कुछ तो पंगा है ना. Let me check what's the problem. Hello, check. Hello. Yeah, there's some problem with the voice, people. Sorry for that. एक सेकेंड मेरे को सेट करना था उसको. Yeah. Just a moment. Until then, you can check out the description box. We have an NCRT channel. So you can check that out. एक सेकेंड रुको है, मेरे को ये माइक को पता नहीं क्या हो गया. जस्ट अ सेकेंड पीपल. एक तो ये विंडोज 10 इज सो वियर्ड. ओके, आई थिंक वी आर गुड टू गो. हेलो, चेक. या बेटर नाउ, आई होप. यस, इट इज स्पीकिंग क्वाइट वेल नाउ. हाँ, आई थिंक अब सही हो गया. यस, हाँ, पता नहीं यार, ये विंडोज 10 थोड़ा वियर्ड. आई एम वेरी सॉरी. या बट आई होप इवन विद द लोअर वॉल्यूम यू कुड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई वाज ट्राइंग टू से, है ना. तो ये आई होप यू गाइस अंडरस्टूड. इफ यू अंडरस्टूड जस्ट राइट अंडरस्टूड ओवर हियर, अदरवाइज आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट अगेन. एनीवे, सो दीज आर योर 3D यूनिट सेल्स. सो NCRT चैनल चेकआउट कर लेना प्लीज. इट्स इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स द लिंक ऑफ इट, राइट. सो नाउ माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, लेट्स सी दीज डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ 3D यूनिट सेल पॉसिबिलिटीज. Then what we'll do, inside these unit cells, we will place our atoms at different points and see what are the variations that we can observe. ठीक है, अपन पहले ये डब्बे देखेंगे, अलग अलग तरह के डब्बे देख रहे हैं अभी अपन बेसिकली. डब्बे देखने के बाद हम देखेंगे कि डब्बों में एटम कहाँ रख सकते हैं ताकि अपने को different टाइप के सेल मिल जाए. ठीक है, कूल. सो दिस इज वॉट इट इज. ऑल राइट, क्रिस्टल सिस्टम कुड बी क्यूबिक. So please write these things down. These are given straight away in the NCRT as well. So you can read it from there after the class if you want, just for revision. So dekho, first is cubic system. How do we make a cube? A cube is made when all the lengths are the same and all the angles are the same, that is 90 degrees. Hai na ji? We can very easily imagine a cube. A is equal to B is equal to C. Iska cube bana do bas. माई ड्रॉइंग इज नॉट दैट गुड. मैं कोशिश करता है क्यूब बनाने की, बट आई एम प्रिटी श्योर ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज आर स्मार्ट इनफ टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट्स गोइंग ऑन. या ऑल द एंगल्स आर 90 डिग्रीज, अ वेरी नाइस डब्बा बॉक्स. या क्यूबिक सिस्टम. सो इन दिस क्यूबिक सिस्टम नाउ पीपल, वॉट वी कैन डू लेटर इज वी कैन प्लेस एटम्स एट डिफरेंट प्लेसेस. वी कैन प्लेस एटम्स एट द कॉर्नर्स मे बी. Yeah, we can place an atom right in the center of the structure. We can place an atom on the edges. We'll see how that looks in 3D, and the 3D diagrams will help you visualize this better. Aayenge us pe, theek hai? Then the next type of cubic system is tetragonal. Okay, next type of cubic system is tetragonal. Over here, what is the difference? Two of the lengths are the same. What does this mean? A is equal to B. It means the base is like a square. Yeah, one of the faces of this 3D structure will be a square. Yes, है ना जी. ठीक है, तो एक square base बनाते हैं. चलो, let's make a square base like this. Okay, I mean this is a square base. It's lying on the desk right now. And C is not equal to A and B. All the angles are still 90 degrees. So ये कैसा एक लंबा सा structure है. Yeah, this is something like this. Like your box from Amazon. This is your rectangular box from Amazon basically, isn't it? मेरे पास पड़ा है डब्बा, मैं दिखाता हूँ, रुको. Yeah, this is what it is. Not exactly. Assume that this side is a square. If this was a square, then this is a tetragonal system. Okay, if this side was a square, then this becomes a tetragonal system. Otherwise, let's look at the next system. Agla system kya hai? Orthorhombic.
What is orthorhombic? A is not equal to B is not equal to C. All sides' lengths are different, but all the angles are the same. So this is your orthorhombic system. Okay. Ali, I am explaining this in a little more detail, bro. ठीक है? तो आज थोड़ा extra detail में सिखा रहा हूँ मैं. Yeah. So this particular box is an orthorhombic system. Okay. You can see this side is different, this side is different, and this side is of different length, but all the angles are still 90 degrees. So this becomes an orthorhombic system. Yeah. Very simple. Chalo. So ab let's go to the next few systems which are a little more entertaining. Yeah. Cubic, tetragonal, orthorhombic, very simple. These are the ideas behind the angles. Okay. Now you come to rhombohedral. Sounds something like a rhombus, isn't it? Let's see what's going on. A is equal to B is equal to C. Okay, very nice. All the lengths are the same. It is very similar to a cube. But the thing is, the angles, even though they are equal, they are not equal to 90 degree. Can you imagine that this rhombohedral thing is nothing but a 3D rhombus? Can you imagine a 3D rhombus? If you can't imagine, it is given over here. Ye raha. Okay. Rhombohedral, it is just a 3D rhombus. All the sides are the same, angles are also same, but the thing is, the angles are not 90 degrees. Aur ye tedha sa square hai. Okay, it's just a tilted square, you can say, it's a tilted cube. Yeah, angles are equal, but theek hai, ye jo angle hai, this angle, this angle, this angle, these angles are equal to each other, but the thing is, it's not 90 degree. The angle may be, let's say, 62 degree, 63 degree or something like that. Chalo. So, ye ho gaye first four systems. I hope you've noted these down. Alright. Before I show you the three more systems, okay, there are three more systems which we have to remember. Sometimes direct questions on these come in the examination, so we should remember these. I hope you're writing them down and making the structures of their 3D images in your notebook as well. So I see a lot of people are asking how to join Vedantu. So my dear friends, Vedantu also has a subscription model. This is called Vedantu's Pro subscription. Okay. So all you need to do in order to enroll into this subscription is open this link, vdnt.in/ytpro. The link is in the description box. The coupon code is phpro. You know what happens when you put a coupon code, you get a discount, yeah? So this subscription is available for 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 12 months. It is your choice where you want to enroll. The subscription is available for 9th class, 10th class, 11th class, 12th class, and for droppers as well. Okay? For all of these people, the subscription is available. You will have daily live classes with the best of educators in the country, yeah? And you will also have access to a lot of study material, tests, assignments, everything that you get in a proper coaching, you will get online over here. So the rates are very cheap. For 12 months, I think you have to pay only 2400 per month or something, even lesser than that. So you can check it out. Okay. The link is in the description box down below. Please make sure you see this if you want to join. All right. Now let's move on to the three further systems. So what are these systems, people? A little more entertaining, a little more complicated. So first we have a hexagonal system. What is this hexagonal system? Over here, A is equal to B, but it is not equal to C. Achha, theek hai. A is equal to B, but it is not equal to C. Alpha and beta are 90 degree, gamma is 120 degree. Ye kya chal raha hai? What is this going on? Ye kya ho gaya? One of the angles is 120 degree, other angles are 90 degree. Let's try to make this one, okay? Let's try to make this one over here. And then I'll show you how this is a hexagon. It might not look like a hexagon when you draw it, but I'll show you why it is called a hexagonal system. So you have A equal to B. So A equal to B hai. Alpha beta equal to 90 degrees. Chalo kuch bana ke dekhte hain, theek hai? Kuch aisa banayenge apan. Alright, this is your base. And then your C is not of the same length. Theek hai? कुछ ऐसा बना देते हैं. फाइन, कैन यू सी? वेरी नाइस, 3D स्ट्रक्चर इज ड्रॉन. ओके, वेरी नाइस, वेरी ब्यूटिफुल 3D स्ट्रक्चर इज ड्रॉन. नाउ द थिंग इज दैट दिस एंगल इज 90 डिग्री. ओके, ये जो एंगल है ये 90 डिग्री है. दिस एंगल इज ऑल्सो 90 डिग्री, यहाँ पे भी 90 डिग्री एंगल दिख रहा होगा आप लोगों को. या विच एंगल इज नॉट 90 डिग्री? लुक एट दिस थर्ड एंगल. दिस एंगल ओवर हियर माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, दिस एंगल इज 120 डिग्रीज. द बेस, दिस लेंथ एंड दिस लेंथ इज द सेम. You have sound effects in the background because of the truck and the horn. Yeah. So this length and this length is the same. The third length is not the same. You have 90 degree angles, but one of the angles is 120 degree. Hey, this doesn't look like a hexagon to me right now. How can this be a hexagon? My dear friends, simply look at this image. Can you spot the smaller structure over here? I'll highlight it with red pen. Okay, red pen hi hai na abhi. Chalo. रेड पेन से इसको हाईलाइट करते हैं. कैन यू सी द स्मॉलर स्ट्रक्चर दैट आई हैव ट्राइड टू ड्रॉ ओवर हियर? इफ यू कंबाइन अ फ्यू ऑफ दोज, या इफ यू कंबाइन अ बंच ऑफ दोज, यू विल एक्चुअली गेट अ हेक्सागन. कैन यू सी दिस रेड थिंग इज व्हाट आई हैव ट्राइड टू ड्रॉ ओवर हियर. दिस एंगल इज योर 120 डिग्री एंगल, ये जो बेस का एंगल है देख रहे हो आप लोग. Yeah, as you know, in a hexagon, the base angle is 120 degree. This angle is 120 degree. Yeah. So when you combine a bunch of these together, you will get an entire hexagonal system. So that is why it is called hexagonal, because a hexagon can be derived out of it. In the previous class, as I told you, that this hexagon can be thought of as a smaller unit as well. Yeah, this smaller unit can be repeated again and again to get the entire hexagon. So the same thing is happening over here. This is the top view of this structure. Fine. So hexagonal system, all you need to remember is A is equal to B, C is longer, alpha is equal to beta, that is 90 degree. One angle is the hexagonal angle, that is 120 degrees. So that's why it's called a hexagonal system. Then you have the monoclinic system. Monoclinic system, and then you have triclinic system. So these are the most asymmetric systems. Let's read about the monoclinic system. A is not equal to B, not equal to C. Okay, great. Lengths are not equal. Alpha equal to gamma equal to 90 degree. Beta is not 90 degree. Ye dekh lo. Monoclinic system. Looks very much like a rectangle, but it's like a squished rectangle. Okay. Looks very much like a cuboid. Aisa hi system hai. But it's like I squish it like this. Okay. Jyada ajeeb ho gaya. Ye thoda weird ho gaya. But I hope you understand what I'm trying to say. Yeah. So imagine this is the rectangle, but this is the angle that we have to change. Okay. This is the 90 degree angle. Right now, all the angles are 90 degree. This is a 90 degree angle. What if I have to change this angle? Thoda sa isko compress kar dunga, to angle change ho jayega. Do you imagine what I'm trying to say? Yeah. If I compress this, now this angle will not be 90 degree anymore. Yeah. I'll try to show you the 3D structures as well, don't worry. And then finally, triclinic is the most asymmetric. Okay? Kuch bhi hai. This is the most asymmetric, most weird. Tedha meda sa, kuch bhi hai bas yahan pe. The shape does not do justice. This is not a very good example in 3D, but triclinic mein, none of the sides are the same, none of the angles are the same. So I tried to look for some websites which had 3D images of these. Yeah. So, मैंने कुछ तो कोशिश की है खोजने की. Just let me try and open it up. यार ये on screen keyboard क्यों खुल जाता पता नहीं. Just a second. Let me try to open that link. चलो जी खोल के देखते हैं. देर इज समथिंग वेरी ब्यूटिफुल ओवर हियर इफ द स्लाइड गेट्स लोडेड. दैट इज इट टेक्स टाइम फॉर दिस टू लोड अप, बट वंस लोडेड आई थिंक वी कैन ट्राई टू सी द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ. यस लोड हो गया, बहुत बढ़िया. सो दीज 7 डिफरेंट सिस्टम्स दैट वी हैव सीन, आउट ऑफ दैट वी विल डिराइव 14 डिफरेंट ब्रावाइस लैटिसेस. व्हाट आर दोज? अपन देखेंगे उसको भी, बट let's see if I can zoom this in. Hey Bhagawan, the page is a little, I mean, this is the only good web page that I could find, but chalo try karte hain fir bhi. Kuch to dikh raha hoga. Let me try to decrease the brightness a little more. so that we can see this a little better. Kuch toh dikhi raha hoga abhi. Let's try to fix the focus a little more. So I'm pretty sure you can see the atoms and all. My face will now be very weirdly black, but I'm sure you get the idea. So right now this is at a cubic system. Okay, this is a cubic system. So isko thoda move karne ki koshish karte hain, which it doesn't move. Brilliant. Thoda sa kuch to move kiya. Can you see the cubic system? Wo ek beech mein cubic cell bana hua hai. Yeah, in the middle you can see a cube over there. Very beautiful. So this is your cubic system. As you can see, all the sides are the same. Yeah, all the sides are pretty much the same length. Thoda thoda difference hai. This animation is not very good. This is the best that I could find online. But yeah, theek hai. So cubic system. Then let's try to look at a different system. If it opens up, khul ja mere bhai. Yeah, then the next one was the tetragonal system where A and B are equal but C is not equal. So can you see this? Lamba ho gaya wo. It became a little longer. Yeah, became a little longer. Tetragonal system. A is equal to B, not equal to C. All the angles are still 90 degree. Yeah, so this is something like your tetragonal system. I know these animations are not the best, but still something is better than nothing. So once let me show you the triclinic structure, if it has a good one. Yep. Ye dekho. Can you see this triclinic structure? Very weird. Gaya bhi ho gaya wo. Yeah, maybe you can see something now. Okay, anyway, let's come back over here. The animation is not that nice. I hoped it would work, but it really didn't. Chalo, koi baat nahi. So these are the different types of unit cells. Now, my dear friends, as I told you, we can place atoms at different positions. So what are the different systems where what are the different positions where we can put our atoms? Dekho, the atoms can either be put at, okay, the atoms can either be put at the corners. Theek hai? Such cells are known as simple cells. The example given over here is a simple cubic cell. Such a cell is known as a simple cell. Atoms or ions present at the corners only. All right. This is known as a simple cell or also a primitive cell. Primitive bole to purana. Primitive bole to old. So this is your simple cell, primitive cell. Atoms are present at the corners. Very, very simple idea. These are the 3D images. We'll explain these a little later. Then you have body centered. What does this mean? That means that inside the system, in the body of the cell, there is one atom at the center. So what is the system? Atoms and ions are present at corners. Also, one of them is at the body center. Corners and body center, both are utilized over here. So as you can see, one atom is at the body center, others are at the corners. So once again, I have a better 3D animation now. Yeah, not the bad, is bari kaafi achha animation mil gaya mere ko for this one. So let's open that now. Cool. So people, this is your simple cubic lattice. Can you see the atoms are there at the corners of the cube? And one thing that you should notice, okay, that inside the cube, the entire atom is not present. Can you see inside the cube only a partial amount of the atom is present? Can you see that? Inside the cube, only a partial amount of atom is present. Wo wala dekho piche jo hai. Can you see that? Only a small amount of the entire atom is present inside the cube. Rest of it is outside the cube. Why so? See, we are talking about a unit cell. It is an imaginary unit which we can repeat again and again to get the entire lattice. Okay? If this is the cube, do you agree that this cube will share its edges and corners with other cubes? Think about a room in your house. That room shares a wall with some other room, right? Yeah? So, if it comes to imagining a lattice out of this unit cell, do you see I can place a cube over here as well? यहाँ पे भी एक क्यूब रख सकता हूँ, एक क्यूब यहाँ पे भी आ जाएगा, एक क्यूब यहाँ पे भी आ जाएगा, वन मोर क्यूब ऑन द टॉप. सो यू कैन कीप पुटिंग क्यूब्स राइट नेक्स्ट टू दिस. इसके साथ डब्बे लगाते जाओ. यस, कीप बॉक्सेस राइट नेक्स्ट टू ईच अदर, समथिंग लाइक दैट. सो इनसाइड वन ऑफ द यूनिट सेल्स, ओके, इनसाइड वन ऑफ द यूनिट सेल्स यू वॉन्ट हैव द एंटायर एटम विच इज प्रेजेंट एट द कॉर्नर्स, ओनली अ सर्टन फ्रैक्शन ऑफ इट इज प्रेजेंट इनसाइड. We'll see how much that fraction is. If you've read the thing earlier from NCERT, you would already know what I'm trying to say. ठीक है, तो वो अपन बाद में देखेंगे कि इसके अंदर कितना आता है. So this is your simple cubic. Let's now try to see the body-centered cubic. ये है body-centered cubic. Can you see this atom, this poor little guy, is present right inside the center? There are atoms at the corners, eight corners, and there are atoms at all the eight corners, and also there is one atom right at the center. Which center? Body center. This is the body of the unit cell. Right in the center, this one, which is fully enclosed inside the unit cell. Okay? So this is your body-centered structure. Okay, this is your बॉडी सेंटर्ड स्ट्रक्चर. मस्त एकदम घूम घुमा के देख लो. ओके, वेरी नाइस. नाउ द नेक्स्ट सिस्टम इज कॉल्ड अ फेस सेंटर्ड सिस्टम. यहां पर भी देखेंगे, ठीक है. द नेक्स्ट सिस्टम इज नोन एज द फेस सेंटर्ड सिस्टम. सो वॉट इज देयर इन द फेस सेंटर्ड सिस्टम? यू हैव एटम्स और आयन्स प्रेजेंट एट द कॉर्नर्स, एंड यू हैव एटम्स प्रेजेंट एट द फेस सेंटर एज वेल. What is a face center? Face is basically the side of the box. ये box है आपके पास. This is the side of the box. Right in the center of this side, there would be an atom. Okay? So that is illustrated over here as well. This diagram is not very clear. So once again, let's go to the 3D imaging. आजा भाई, हाँ ये देखो, ये काफी सही दिख रहा है. Let me move it around and you'll see what's going on. Can you see? Right in the center of all the faces, you have one atom. Can you quickly tell me how much of this atom is inside the cube? Is atom ka kitna bhaag cube ke andar hai? What part of the atom is present inside the cube? Just take one of the face-centered atoms. Okay, this is a face-centered atom. How much of this atom is inside the cube? How much of the atom is outside the cube? Fatafat se batao. I'm pretty sure you can see over here. Can you see these two hemispheres? Yeah, can you see? So there are atoms at all the corners, and then there are atoms at all the faces. Yes, absolutely. So Azima, Devi, Gautam, Hari Krishnan, and Saran and Study and Gamer, Rudra, Shravani, Priyanshi, very, very good. Lot of people giving me the correct answer. Only half of the atom which is present at the face center is inside the unit cell. Body center mein the entire atom was inside the unit cell. And the corner. How do we imagine a corner? Let me tell you how to imagine a corner. Okay. How to imagine a corner? Take a face centered case. Okay. Take a face centered case and divide it into four parts. I'll tell you how. Isko thoda aise banate hain. Yeah. Let's try to divide this particular box into more cubes. Okay, so I'll try to draw it for you. Let's cut this guy into these halves. My dear friends, how much is this now? Just this part, how much is this? If I cut a sphere into four halves, this is 1/4 of a sphere. Yeah, this is 1/4 of a sphere. Now, how much of this 1/4 is inside समझ रहे हो ना बात को. वी हैड एन एंटायर स्फेयर, वी कट दैट एंटायर स्फेयर इनटू फोर हाफ्स. सो दिस इज वन फोर्थ वन फोर्थ वन फोर्थ वन फोर्थ, बेसिकली मेड फोर क्वाड्रेंट्स. या वन फोर वन फोर वन फोर्थ वन फोर्थ. नाउ हाउ मच ऑफ दिस वन फोर्थ इज इनसाइड, हाउ मच ऑफ दिस वन फोर्थ इज आउटसाइड? हाफ ऑफ दिस वन फोर्थ इज इनसाइड, हाफ ऑफ द वन फोर्थ इज आउटसाइड. या सो वन फोर्थ का हाफ जो है दैट इज इनसाइड एंड दैट इज इक्वल टू वन एट्थ. कैन यू सी द रिजेंबलेंस ऑफ दिस गाय विद दिस गाय? नाउ ये रिजेंबलेंस दिख रही है आपको? या लेट्स हाईलाइट द रिजेंबलेंस विद अ ब्लैक कलर. कैन यू सी दिस पार्ट एंड दिस पार्ट आर एग्जैक्टली द सेम? या दिस वन फोर्थ का हाफ इज इनसाइड, यहां पे भी दिस वन फोर्थ का हाफ इज इनसाइड. ओके, गॉट इट? सो व्हेनेवर एन एटम इज प्रेजेंट एट अ कॉर्नर, व्हेनेवर एन एटम इज प्रेजेंट एट द कॉर्नर, वन एट्थ ऑफ इट इज इनसाइड द सेल. ठीक है. सो अभी तक क्या सीखा अपन ने? वी हैव लर्न्ड व्हाट आर सिंपल systems, primitive systems. We have learnt what is body-centered system. We have learnt what is face-centered system. Now, if an atom is present at the corner, if an atom is present at the corner, this contributes to 1/8 inside the cell. If the atom is present at the face center, half of it inside the cell. Okay? And my dear friends, if I have something at the body center, this entire thing, this entire unit one is inside the unit cell. Understood? 3D images help. What you can imagine once again is, think about a room. Okay, you are sitting inside a room. There is a cubic room. Think about a very simple cubic room. Okay, if there is an atom present inside the room, the atom is present inside the room. ठीक है, हो गया, मतलब that one entire thing is present inside the room. Now think that the half of the atom is coming out of one of the walls. Okay, एक दीवार imagine करो अपने room में, and half of the atom is coming out of that wall. This is the wall, and only half of the atom is coming outside the wall. Half of the atom is in the other room. Yeah, so that is your face centered. And now you can imagine in one of the corners, okay? Now you can imagine in one of the corners one atom is present. Only 1/8 of that atom will be inside your room. Other 1/8 will be in all the other rooms that the corner shares. Okay? The corner of a cube is shared by 8 cubes totally. है ना जी? ठीक है, अगर आप सोच के देखोगे, इफ यू ट्राई टू मेक मोर क्यूब्स ओवर हियर, दिस कॉर्नर कैन बी शेयर्ड बाय 8 क्यूब्स इन 3 डायमेंशंस. या सो इफ यू इमेजिन योर साइड योर सेल्फ इन अ रूम, ऑन द कॉर्नर इफ यू इमेजिन एन एटम, 1/8 ऑफ इट इज इनसाइड योर ओन रूम, एज वी अंडरस्टूड फ्रॉम द इमेजेस एज वेल. वेरी सिंपल, राइट? एंड दीज आइडियाज आर लिटरली द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट इन सॉलिड स्टेट. This idea is literally the most important in solid state. If you understand this, you will be able to solve a lot of questions very easily. Yeah, we are trying to build the very basics of this chapter of solid state. So, ye ho gaya apna idea. Now, let us get back over here. Then, the last system is a little weird. It is known as the end-centered. The end-centered, kya, I'll tell you. This is very rare, okay? This is very rare. End-centered systems, we will never study these again, by the way. Maybe in some question they will ask you, but these are very rare systems. What is happening inside end-centered systems? Atoms or ions are present at the corners and only at two opposite faces. Instead of face-centered, you take away some of the atoms, you get some structure like this. Yeah, so you have atoms at all the corners. Yeah, can you see? All the corners have atoms and only two of the face centers have atoms. Only opposite faces have atoms, just one pair. Rest of them have no atoms at all. So this is found only in orthorhombic and monoclinic systems. Theek hai? So we've studied all the different types of systems. This end-centered system is found only in the case of orthorhombic and monoclinic systems. Okay? Chalo, ye bhi ho gaya. So yahan pe, let's see if they have चलो ये यहाँ ने तीन ही दिए इन्होंने, सिंपल क्यूबिक, बॉडी सेंटर्ड एंड फेस सेंटर्ड. दोज आर द इंपॉर्टेंट वंस. एंड सेंटर्ड इज जस्ट अ स्पेशल केस ऑफ द फेस सेंटर्ड केस. फेस सेंटर्ड सिस्टम का जस्ट एक स्पेशल केस है. नाउ माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, देयर इज वन मोर क्वेश्चन आई वॉन्ट टू आस्क यू. लेट मी सी वेयर आई हैव अ ब्लैंक पेज. चलो एक क्वेश्चन पूछता हूँ आपसे मैं. लेट अस थिंक ऑफ क्यूबिक सेल. सिंपल सा क्यूबिक सेल बनाते हैं. And what I will do now in this cubic cell, okay? What I will do in this cubic cell is I will place an atom at the edge center. Do you agree that this is the edge of the cell? This is the edge of the cell. This is the edge of the cell. This is the edge of the cell. So what I will do is I will place an atom at the center of the edge. ठीक है? My question to you is, how much of this is inside the क्यूब? हाउ मच ऑफ दिस इज इन साइड द सेल? पीपल कैन यू टेल मी? क्या बता सकते हो? वॉट यू हैव टू इमेजिन इज इन साइड योर रूम यू हैव वन स्फेयर कमिंग आउट ऑफ द एज ऑफ योर रूम. एकदम कोने में जो दीवार है ना, वेयर टू वॉल्स मीट, ओवर हेयर यू हैव वन एटम. सो कैन यू इमेजिन हाउ मच इज दिस? कैन यू इमेजिन हाउ मच इज दिस? The hint is look at it from this direction. यहां से देखने की कोशिश करो. Look at it from this direction. How do you draw the eye? ऐसा कुछ बनाते हैं ना. Yeah. Try to look at it from this direction. ऐसा side से देखने की कोशिश करो जरा. If I look at it from the side, what does it look like? If I look at it from the side, it looks something like this. Can you see? This is the view that I've drawn over there. If I look at it from this side, ऐसा कोने से देखेगा मैं. Yeah, this is where I'm looking at it from. This is what I'll see. Can you see? If I make more cubes, I'm dividing it into four halves. So this is 1/4 of the sphere. So if in a question they ask you that one atom is present at the edge center of a cube, okay, this particular position is known as the edge center. If the atom is present at the edge center of a unit cell, only 1/4 of it will be inside the unit cell. Okay, this is just a very theoretical case. Hardly will they ask you, but I wanted to tell you about this. So how much of it is inside the cell? Only 1/4. Cool. So just keep this in your mind as well. I know solid state mein 90% of the job is done if you are able to visualize these things in 3D. Chalo, toh wapas chalte hain pehle. Now, what's going on, people? How many systems did we have? We had 7 systems. Can you see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And in these 7 systems, what are the possibilities? The possibilities are simple cubic, body centered, face centered, end centers. So what's the total number of possibilities? Total number of possibilities is how much? 4 × 7. Total possibilities come out to be 4 × 7, that is equal to 28. These are the total number of theoretical possibilities of different types of unit cells that we can make. Okay, we can have, let's say, a triclinic system where, you know, you have a body-centered system. So in that triclinic unit cell, you will have atoms at all the corners and you will have a body center atom. Yeah. So the thing is that these 28, all of them don't exist in nature. Okay, these 28 all don't exist in nature. ये सभी जो हैं, ये नेचर में एग्जिस्ट नहीं करते. ओनली अ फ्यू ऑफ दीज एग्जिस्ट इन नेचर. ओनली 14 ऑफ दीज एग्जिस्ट इन नेचर. व्हाट आर दोज आर नोन एज ब्रावाइस लैटिसेस. अब समझ आया क्या होता है ब्रावाइस लैटिस? दोज आर नोन एज ब्रावाइस लैटिसेस. ब्रावाइस लैटिसेस ऑफ 7 क्रिस्टल सिस्टम्स. क्यूबिक सिस्टम में out of the 4 cases, only 3 are found. What are those 3 forms that are found? Simple cubic is found, body centered is found, face centered is found. In nature, no cubic एंड सेंटर्ड सेल इज फाउंड. ठीक है, नेचर में क्यूबिक सिस्टम में एंड सेंटर्ड सेल नहीं मिलता है. ऑलराइट, दैट्स द आइडिया. इन नेचर इन अ क्यूबिक क्रिस्टल सिस्टम यू विल नॉट हैव द एंड सेंटर्ड यूनिट सेल्स एनीवेयर. कूल. Then you have the tetragonal system. Only two types of Burmese lattices are formed. Do you must be wondering, sir, do we have to remember all of this? No. Okay. No need to remember this. Just read it out once. Ek bar dekhna hai toh dekh lo. Just remember that there are overall 14 Burmese lattices. You don't need to remember this information. This is too much information for anyone to remember. Okay. Only orthorhombic can show all the four types of lattices. Others can only show one or two different types of lattices. So total Burmese lattices are 14. Seven different crystal systems and four different arrangements totally possible. Only few of them exist. So this is another diagram that I have over here. Another table that I have over here. Which tells you what are the different types of systems possible. ठीक है, so cubic में you have only 3 possible, tetragonal में you have 2 possibilities, orthorhombic में you have all 4 possibilities, monoclinic में only 2 possibilities, you have only the, you know, in triclinic, trigonal, hexagonal, 1-1-1 possibility. ठीक है, so the idea is total number of Burmese lattices are only 14. Not 28, because all the arrangements are not possible in all the systems. Simple idea, no need to remember too much of it. Just remember there are 14 Burmese lattices. ठीक है? So this is something that we've already visualized. Corner atom, there are 8 corners in a cube. Each atom in the corner is shared among 8 unit cells, so its contribution is 1/8. We've already understood. Can you see? This is how we can imagine a unit cell where things are at the corners. Can you see the diagram? ये diagram अच्छे से समझ आ रहा होगा. Yeah, this entire sphere has been cut into the only part that is inside the unit cell. ठीक है ना? Similarly, you have face centered. Can you see this very beautiful image? So there are atoms at the corners. ये एक sphere था corner वाला जिसको काट दिया. And there is half of this sphere. Yeah, there is half of this sphere at the face center. Very beautiful diagrams given to you. So face centered ki the contribution of this is 1/2. Very simple. Ye bhi ho gaya. Yeah. Then next you had body center. The entire sphere is inside the body center, as you can see. You know, one entire sphere is inside the body center. Rest are the corners which are cut into 1/8. And then edge centered. I've already told you. Edge centered mein this contributes to just 1/4. If you have something present over here, 1/4 of it is inside the square cell, inside the unit cell. So pretty simple ideas. Let us try to use these ideas to solve this question. Chalo ji, ab apan thoda sawal karte hain. Let's try to have some more fun solving questions. Very nice question, okay? A compound formed by elements X and Y has a cubic structure. Let's first try to make a cube. You can make this in your mind as well. No need to draw it. If your imagination is strong, you can do this question verbally as well. Okay. And if you are hearing random noises in the background, my kittens are playing with the box that I was showing you. Okay. तो एकदम मस्त यहाँ उछल कूद चल रही है उनकी. All right. ठीक है. तो चलो. बालाजी सिंह, KVPY 2020 is delayed. Will JEE mains get delayed? बालाजी, JEE main 2021 most likely will be delayed. Okay, most likely there was a report that JEE main 2021 might not happen in January. It might be delayed. ठीक है. चलो तो ये क्यूबिक सेल बन गया. Now what is being said that X atoms are at the corner of the cube. Okay, so there are X atoms at the corner of the cube. चलो बना देते हैं. ठीक है, there is one more in the middle. Let's try to draw that. It will not look very beautiful, but फिर भी बनाने की कोशिश करते हैं. Yeah, so there is one X atom over here. So my dear friends, how many total X atoms are there in this particular unit cell? Can we write that? I'll write total X atoms. My dear friends, how will we calculate this? I can calculate this by multiplying the number of corners into contribution at each corner. Contribution at each corner. This is what I have to do. How many corners are there inside a cube? Of course, there are 8 corners. So, yahan pe 8 likh dete hain. 8 corners. And what is the contribution of a corner atom inside the unit cell? We just understood that 2-3 slides back. Contribution is 1 by 8. So, this is equal to 1. So, because X is present at all corners, overall, one atom of X is present inside the unit cell. I hope you understand that this analysis is theoretical. In nature, you cannot cut out one unit cell from a lattice. You can't have 1/8 of an atom, right? That will create a lot of destruction in the world. That will destroy a nuclear bomb. Ban jayega. Wo nahi karna apne ko. Imaginary hai. This is just imaginary. So you can imagine that overall, one X atom is present inside the unit cell by the virtue of it being present at all the corners. Yeah? Right? Now let us look at why. Kya hai yahan pe? X atoms are at the corner. This is simple. And two atoms are at each body diagonal of the cube. What is a body diagonal now? Let me try to show you an image. What is a body diagonal? How many body diagonals are there? And then at every body diagonal, I have to place two Y atoms. Ye dekho. This is a cube. Can you see the faint lines in the middle? I'll just highlight one of those lines. Okay. I'll just highlight one of those lines. This is a body diagonal from one corner to the opposite corner. Ye hai aapka body diagonal. Can you see? So in your room, you can imagine from one corner to the other corner. Aisa. Mast. All right. Yeah. Both Billu and Leon are playing over here in the cardboard box that I showed you. Mast khel rahe hain dono. Anyway, so this is a body diagonal. So how many body diagonals can you see in the structure? This is one of the body diagonals. I can see two. This is your third one and this is your fourth one. I can see four body diagonals. Yes. Now let us imagine that on these body diagonals, Y is present two times. Yeah. Y is present two times at one body diagonal. So if I'm looking at, let's say this body diagonal, theek hai, isko thoda aur highlight karte hain. This is the body diagonal that I am looking at. One Y is present, let's say over here. The other Y will also be present over here. Do you realize that both the Ys are completely inside the cell? Do you realize that these are completely inside the cell? Inside the cell. Imagine a line going from one corner to the other in your room. In the middle of that line, there is an atom. In the middle of that line, there is another atom. Both the atoms are totally inside your room, right? So atoms on the body diagonals are completely inside the cell. There are four body diagonals. There are two Ys per body diagonal. So total number of Y is equal to 2 into 4 body diagonals, that is 8. Theek hai ji? So these are your body diagonals. Those are where Y is present. To wapas jayenge. What becomes the answer over here, my dear friends? The answer becomes, there is 1 X, there are 8 Ys. So total number of atoms in the cube is equal to 9. Total number of atoms are 9. Yes. And what is the formula? Formula becomes XY8. Done. Okay. Yeah. Gautam is saying once show the kittens. Let's try. Arey, bhagengi ab. Ye dekho, ek to nikal gayi. She ran off. And this guy is sitting over here. Can you see? There he is. Blue. Ja. Anyway. Aditya Singh, so please help to geometrically represent tetrahedral and octahedral voids. We'll do that eventually, bro. Not today, but eventually when I teach you about voids, we will do that. Okay. So yeah, this is the question. ठीक है जी, चलो आगे चलते हैं. The next question now, my dear friends, this one pretty simple, okay, pretty simple, but just a new line has been added. If all atoms from one body diagonal of the cube except corners are removed, calculate the effective number of atoms and the formula of the compound. This particular question now is the homework for you guys. All you have to do is answer in the comment section. Yes, we will take the names of a few people who answer this question correctly in the next class. When is the next class of solid state? Next class of solid state is going to be on, aaj kya tarikh hai bhaiya, today is the 7th, yeah, so we will have the next class on the 9th of this month, that is Wednesday at 7 p.m. okay, so we have classes for all of you 12th class students on Mondays, Wednesdays and Fridays at 7 p.m. so the next class of solid state will be on 9 September, Wednesday 7 p.m. this is your homework question, you have to answer it in the comment section down below. Fine, काफी simple है, काफी अच्छा question है, just involves a little bit more imagination than what was there in the previous question. Yes, चलो जी, ये हो गया, this is done. बढ़िया, तो दोस्तों टेक्निकली स्पीकिंग द क्लास इज ओवर. या द गुड थिंग इज दैट वी हैव एन एनसीईआरटी चैनल एज वेल. लॉट ऑफ पीपल फेस डिफिकल्टीज सॉल्विंग एनसीईआरटी, रीडिंग एनसीईआरटी, सो इफ यू नीड समवन टू टीच यू वट एवर देर इन द एनसीईआरटी, वेदांतु हैज अ चैनल फॉर दैट. इट्स कॉल्ड एनसीईआरटी 11th एंड 12th. द लिंक इज इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स डाउन बिलो. आई एम प्रीटी श्योर ऑल ऑफ यू नो वेयर द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स इज. एंड ऑल्सो वेदांतु ऑल्सो हैज सब्सक्रिप्शंस. यस, vdnt.in/ytpro is the link where you can go to enroll into Vedantu's pro subscription. You will have regular live classes on Vedantu's patented platform. You will have lots of assignments, tests, question banks, materials given to you, sab tarah ka jo bhi hota hai, whatever you get in a coaching institute, every weekend there will be a test, you will be ranked in the test. So all sorts of advantages that you get in a coaching institute, you will get in this Vedantu Pro subscription. The link is in the description box down below. And in case you want a discount, which I'm pretty sure you do, you can use the coupon code called PHPRO. Alright, so now I will just chat with you guys for 2-3 minutes and then we will call it a day. So today's class was again, chalte firte ho gaya. It was just a discussion class. We didn't really, you know, learn anything new or anything special. We just tried to use our visualization to understand the different names. Yeah, sirf naam samjhe apan ne aaj. What is monoclinic? What is triclinic? What is orthorhombic? What is body centered? So we've just used the imaginations that already existed in our brain and associated it with a few more names. From the next class onwards, when we start doing some questions and calculations on these particular cells, when we start understanding what are voids, how proper crystal lattices are formed, that is when the chapter starts getting into a lot more fun. Since this is a proper regular class series, we are going a little slow. Chalo ji. So someone is saying how to get interest in study. Vijay, just read the NCERT before bedtime, man, and I'm pretty sure you will enjoy a lot of things that they're given the NCERT. When you think of study as a core, when you think of study as a burden, it feels really bad. Don't think of it as study. Think of it as reading some fun book. NCERT is very fun if you read it like that. Just lie in your bed at night and aise dekhne ka NCERT. You'll definitely enjoy it. Okay. Try that once, Vijay. I am pretty sure that will help you build a lot of interest. Trimurti, yes. Hulalala subscription is for Pluti. Yeah. Trishank is saying, in your opinion on mains chemistry, is it hard or moderate? Easy to moderate. yeah, somewhere in that region, easy to moderate. It was a little bit factual in nature. There were a bunch of questions which required you to remember some structure or some name or some formula. So those questions can't really be called difficult or easy because those are memory based questions. So I saw a lot of memory based questions this time around in mains. Yeah. Pranav, I'm glad my classes helped, man. Jugraj is saying, but Erodov is not fun reading. You don't have to read Erodov. You have to solve questions in Erodov. And once you learn, I mean, not learn, once you realize how much fun it is to solve Erodov's questions, you will become addicted. Our teachers, when we were studying in 11th, told us not to do Erodov because it is addictive. Okay, one question takes like half an hour. Some questions are there that take half a day. You're just trying to think of it. Achha, ye kaise hoga? Where is that thing? How will it move, etc. And once you get addicted to that thought process, you can't leave Erodov. So, Erodov is a lot of fun if you understand what kind of fun it is. See, fun is not always about dancing and singing. There are other types of fun as well. Thinking, invigorating and intriguing thinking is also one type of fun. Yeah, and thank you so much for all of your compliments, people. Glad you're enjoying things that are going on over here. Harish, what's up, man? Gaurav is saying, please make a strategy session for JEE Advanced. Okay, Gaurav, suggestion taken. I can do that very soon. I'll tell you in brief what the strategy should be. Every alternate day, solve a JEE Advanced level mock test. JEE Advanced level mock test means 3 hours, 2 hours break, 3 hours advanced level questions. That's all you have to do every alternate day. Just change the type of questions that you are solving to prepare for JEE Advanced. Yeah, that's all. Theek hai? Badhiya. Abhinav, I'm glad you're understanding the classes over here, man. Yeah, Abhinav, the plan is to cover all the chapters eventually. It will take time, but we'll try to cover all the chapters. Chalo, people, that's it from my side today. Thank you so much for all of your compliments. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you hit that thumbs up button. Stay subscribed to this channel because I'm going to see you very soon. Next class on solid state will be on Wednesday at 7 p.m. If you want to join Vedantu subscription, the details are in the description box down below. Until next time, take care.